Hello everyone, welcome to Programming Cradle. Few days back, I posted a short video asking in which course you guys are interested in so that I can do my research and I can review that course. So most of you shouted about Great Lakes Data Science course. So I reached out to several people and I asked them some of the important questions. I have noted down actually all those questions so that I don't forget to answer them in this video. And I also noted it down way before asking those people because I wanted to ask all these questions. And I will highly suggest you to ask these questions before taking any course. So yeah, some of the courses like how is the teaching, how is the course content and support from placement team, and if you have some doubt, how will they clear, how will they help you in building your portfolio, and what can be the median salary. Also, if you miss some classes, how will you manage to attend those classes, and how will they help you in interview preparation and networking, and also what if they are not able to place you, will they take any responsibility. And the last but not the least, and I think that is probably the most important question, is it worth the money? Because when you are going for courses like UpGrad or Great Lakes, you will be paying more than 2.5 lakhs and it is actually a very big amount. So yeah, you need to have that peace of mind that yes, it is worth the money, and I will probably get what I'm paying for. So yeah, we are going to answer all these questions in this video. I reached out to multiple people like I told you, and whatever feedback I got from them, I will be explaining that in this video. So yeah, that's exactly what we'll be discussing in this video. But before moving further, as always, if you are new here or if you haven't subscribed to the channel, please go ahead, subscribe to the channel and be a part of Programming Cradle family, and also hit that bell icon so that you get notified each time when a video goes live. And if you end up finding this video helpful, please give it a thumbs up. It keeps me motivated to make such videos for you guys. And if you have anything specific, you can always let me know in the comment section. I will be more than happy to help you, and I try to explain my answers to the best of my knowledge. So yeah, and also if you have some other course which you want me to review, do my research and then review it, I will make a short video again, and you can post your comments or the courses in that video's comment section, because it will be easy for me to have a track of all the courses which you guys are interested in. And if I start going through all the videos comment section, it will be really hard for me to compile the data, like which course is most shouted out. So yeah, that's why I will post a short video and you can make your comment in that video. So now with that being said, let's start our discussion. So the first question is, how is the teaching? So I asked to multiple people and everybody were like, yeah, I was a complete beginner and whatever they were teaching, I was able to understand properly. And even I went to their YouTube channel and I tried looking for the courses and I tried looking for few videos here and there, and actually their teaching is perfectly fine and they're teaching very good. So even if you are a beginner, you will be able to pick up things properly. Now, how is the course content? So the course content is good actually. It is sufficient enough to get you a job in the job market. And for course content, I think I'm almost all the courses are fine. They are providing the course content to the par of industry and whatever is needed for you to be a data scientist in the industry, it is sufficient enough. So yeah, content wise course is perfectly fine. Now the next question is, how they help you in the placement, or how is the placement team? So here's the thing is, they actually have their separate portal, and there they will post all the openings and you can go there and you can apply on your own. So they will help you in making resume and all those things. So yeah, once you are done with the course, you are ready with your profile and your resume, you can apply on to their portal, and if you get shortlisted, you will go for the interview, and after that you will be, it's just like a normal interview, like if you apply on a like Indeed or maybe on Naukri.com. so it is same like that, but it is their own portal, so you will be applying there, so probably you will have higher chances of getting shortlisted. Now the next thing is, if you have some doubt, how will they clarify that? So they have they most of the time clear your doubt in the within the class. It goes same for live classes or in-person classes. So it goes same for both. They most of the time clear your doubts within the class, and if you still have some doubt, you can always ask them after the class, and they also organize some separate classes for clearing the doubts. So I think that would be sufficient enough to get your doubts cleared. Now the next question is how they are helping in building the portfolio or profile. So they help you to post your portfolio or the projects on your LinkedIn, and they help you to build your LinkedIn look much better, or it should look appealing to the employer, because nowadays LinkedIn plays a very important role as part of your profile. And if you send your resume, people or the recruiter, they tend to look for the GitHub profile and LinkedIn profile. So yeah, you need to have a good LinkedIn profile as well. So they will help you to make your LinkedIn profile look better, and also they will help you to organize your project and how to put them in your resume. So they will help you all in all. So yeah, that is also a good thing. Now the next thing is what is the median salary. So this is something what I couldn't get a proper reply from people, because they don't really know how much people are getting. So on their website they have mentioned like 20 lakh is the highest package, I guess, and 5 to 6 lakh median salary. So with this, I think we have to go with the statistics what they have provided on their website. But if we go to the least, probably you will get 4 lakh or more than 4.5 lakh. I think you will get more than that, but let's say you can expect 4 to 4.5 lakh. So in my opinion, spending 2.5 lakh to get 4.5 lakh, that might not be worth, but still, if you are an experienced person, probably you will be able to fetch much higher package, and probably you will get a hike of around 50 to 100% or maybe even more. So that will be possible for sure. So yeah, let's move on to our next question, and we will summarize everything at the end of this video. So yeah, the next question is what if you miss some classes. So they will have all the classes recorded, and you can go to your profile and you can watch all those recorded sessions. So if you miss some classes, that's not a problem. You can always go back and watch all those lecture videos. Now the next question is how they help you in interview and networking. So networking, like I told you, they will help you to build your LinkedIn profile. So with that, you will be able to attract more people who are interested in data science. And also for interview preparation, they conduct several mock interviews, and they give you feedback on which topic you are not very confident enough, or you are not doing very well. So you will have to prepare on those topics, and then they will again take your mock interview, and again they will give you feedback, and if you are improving or not, they will tell you like that. It will be same as your real interview, but here you will get a proper feedback where you need to improve and where you are doing well. So yeah, they are helping you with the mock interview so that you can perform well in your real interview. So far so good. But what if they are not able to place you? Important question, right? So here things go a little bit on the darker side, I should say, because if they are not able to place you, they won't take any responsibility. It's totally up to you if you get placed or not. But yeah, there all the resources will be available for you for 3 years, so you can use those resources to learn, to grow, or to get placed. You will have access to that portal where they post their job openings, so you can always reach out to the companies. So what I would suggest you is, when you see the opening there, don't apply onto their portal. Go to the LinkedIn, find few people from that company and try to build a relation. It might take a month or maybe even 2 months, but it is worth it actually, because if you apply on their portal, maybe they will reject your resume, and that's it, it's end, right? But if you reach out to the people from that company and you know that there is an opening, or you can, what you can do is you can go to their website and the company's website, and you can find what are openings they have, and whatever openings they have, you can directly apply onto their website. So maybe you will have more chances of getting shortlisted there, because they won't know that you have completed the course from Great Lakes, and probably if you have some prior experience, you can show some part of your experience as if you had experience in data analytics. So they will think you have experience in a relevant field. So your chances will increase of getting shortlisted, and probably if you have good knowledge, you will be able to crack the interview as well. So now the last question, but the very important question in my opinion, is it worth the money? So if you are fresher, I would directly say no, it's not worth. People have told me that like the people who have already taken the course, they told me that people with zero experience or people with experience but irrelevant experience, they find it really hard to get a job, and it's really hard to get their resume shortlisted even on Great Lakes portal. So that is the thing. And if you are paying like 2.5 lakh and still finding it hard to get your resume shortlisted in the first place, I would say it is totally not worth it. And also they told me that if people had experience of around 2 to 4 years or maybe 5 years, they were able to get calls for the interview, and after that it's totally up to you how's your knowledge and how well you can do in the interview. So the first and the very most important thing is getting call, and people with some experience, they were able to get calls because they had experience and they actually showed some part of their experience as to they worked in the relevant field, like data analytics or data engineering and or big data. So like that, they were showing their experience. So because of that, they were getting calls. So that's the thing. And in my opinion, or actually I have seen this, because when you go to some level of promotion or some job role, you will need some certification or degree for further promotions. So if you are having some experience, probably at that time PG courses are important for you or will be helpful for you. But if you are fresher or just getting started, I think for you, just doing a certificate course, gain some good knowledge, good grasp over the concepts, and start apply and do some good projects and build a very great portfolio, and then start applying to the companies, you will be just fine. You don't really need PG courses, diploma courses. So yeah, that's the thing. But if you are someone who is already having some amount of experience, and probably in near future you will reach to some extent where you will need some certification or master's degree or something like that for further promotions, for you PG courses will be fine. Because in my past company Infosys, I was working there, so there was actually two guys who were in contention of promotion. So one was he was from a good college, actually I don't remember the college, but he had that master's degree, and the other one didn't have master's degree. He was just out of he had the bachelor's degree just, but the amount of experience, they both had same amount of experience, they had the same caliber, but they promoted the one with the master's degree. So that's what I'm talking about, and same goes for PG diploma also. So yeah, if you are experienced, go for the course. Probably it will be worth the money for you. But still, there are some courses which are way cheaper than these courses, and if you do those courses, you will be just fine, and probably you will be able to get job in the market. So I personally think it is not worth the money, spending 2.5 lakhs. Yeah, so the bottom line is, for me it's not worth the money, but for you it might be something different, and you might be looking something different in the course. So I would highly suggest you to make your informed and wise decision. So yeah, this is what I wanted to discuss in this video. I hope you found this video helpful. Please give it a thumbs up, it keeps me motivated to make such videos for you guys, and it takes quite a lot of effort to make such videos, reaching out to people, sending them connection, waiting for them to accept the connection, and then messaging them, and then waiting for them to reply me back. So yeah, it takes actually quite a lot of time and effort. So yeah, please respect that and give this video a like and subscribe to the channel. I keep bringing such informative videos for you guys. So yeah, hope to see you in the next video. Bye. Happy learning.